Hey guys, what we have here is a little project I've been working on since last year, which is Atari's Gauntlet implemented in an FPGA. This is the source code that I've been slaving over for months on end, and if you need to recall what the game looks like, we have a little main here which runs in debug mode, and this is what the game should look like. Now, on this side, we have the hardware that the implementation is running on, which is a Pipistrellia board, which unfortunately is discontinued, and it's pretty hard to get one. But anyway, it's open source, and you can probably find the board and schematic files that you need to build one yourself. Or alternatively, you can just adapt this to run on any platform you have, such as, for example, Mister. I'm sure that's relatively easily doable with a bit of effort. Now, what we have here is the actual board, and then we have a custom additional board which has some memory chips on it. On one side, we have a very fast 10 nanosecond static RAM chip, which is 2 megs by 16 bits, so a total of 4 megabytes in total. And on the other side, we have a flash chip, which is not actually used in this implementation, but it's there for any future needs that we might have. Now, at this point in time, what I've done is I've commented out the audio section, so this is the board will not make any sounds at all. However, the main processor ROMs are stored inside the FPGA, whereas the video ROMs are stored in this little serial flash chip over here. Now, because it's serial, it's actually fairly slow, and it's not possible to run the game with the video ROM stored entirely in the serial chip. So what happens is at reset or power on, the contents of this chips, the ROMs for the video circuitry, are copied into this external static RAM chip, which is then being used as an external ROM. So remember, the game ROMs, the main 68,000 processor ROMs, are inside the FPGA. The video ROMs are on an external chip, and the audio is not there at all. So at this point in time, if we power up the board one-handed, let's see what happens. And hook up the video. The game should run. And it looks a little weird, mainly because the video ROMs are not present. The text is stored in an additional ROM, which is also on the FPGA. That's why you can see the text. And that's why the game is running at the moment. However, if we plug in the hat carefully so as not to blow up anything, what you can see is that the contents of the RAM are currently random. So if we hit the reset button, now the game should look like what it looks in MAME. So I'll let the game run for a little while with the MAME on the left-hand side as comparison and the actual FPGA game running on the right-hand side. They're not entirely synchronized, but as it happened, they're reasonably close. So the problem I'm having at the moment is basically I'm trying to have all the ROMs stored in the external memory on the additional board. So there is a slight problem with timing. If I have all the ROMs stored here and trying to be accessed simultaneously, then the game has some issues, mostly manifested in either the processor will crash because it's unable to fetch its instructions from the external memory. Or if I prioritize, for example, the processor, then the video will suffer and there will be video artifacts on the screen. So I'm going to continue working on that, and hopefully, maybe not too long from now, we'll have a fully running game. Oh, and additionally, I should probably explain that the audio is running It's based on there's three sound sources. There's the Pokey, there's a Yamaha FM synthesizer, and then there's a speech synthesizer, which I have not implemented. And that is probably going to be fairly time consuming and a fair amount of work that I might need help with from someone in the community.